Hi children, good morning. How are you? Very good. You are all fine. Nice. So, you have already learnt about the previous chapter. What is the previous chapter? Number system. About the number system, few days back, already you have learnt. In the number system, what we use? What are the numbers we use? And how many numerals we use, and using the numerals, how to write a big number or how to write a small number. Just once we refer about that. What are the numerals we use in writing the numbers? What are the numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many? Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 numbers are there. Using these 10 numerals, using these 10 numerals, we can write any big number or small number. Any big number we can write using these 10 numerals. In all these 10 numbers, what is the smallest one? 0 is the smallest one. Okay. And using these 9 digits, we can write any big number. Now, and in the Indian system, this is called Indian system. In the Indian system, how many numerals we are using? 10 numerals we are using. And what is the use of these 10 numerals? We can write any big number using these 10 numerals. Right. Next one. What is the place value system in the Indian system? What is the place value system? In the place value chart, we start from units place. Units, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores, 100 crores, 1000 crores, like that we proceed in the Indian system. And in this system, we can write the ascending order and descending order. What is meant by ascending order? Small to big. If we write the numbers from small to big, that is called ascending order. Or this is also called as increasing order. Next one is descending order. Descending order means big to small. Big to small. This is a descending order. Ascending order means small to big. So like this, we write the numbers in ascending order and descending order. About that also already have said. Just we are revealing about the previous topic. And next one, which is small one, which is big one also, we can share it, numbers. If some numbers are given, then we can say that which is the small one and which is the big. What is the symbol of greater than? This is the greater than symbol. What is the symbol of less than? Less than. For example, you see, 10 is greater than 9. 10 is greater than 9. For this one example, 39 is less than 57. This is less than. So, greater than, about the greater than, less than, we study. So, by keeping all these points in view, slowly we are coming to the next system. Indian system of the next one, Roman system is there. Romans
seven symbols. To write any big number, they use the seven symbols only. Children, now we are going to the next topic. That is the second chapter, Roman numerals. In the Indian system, how many symbols we use, how many digits are symbols we use in Indian system? 10. Now, in the Roman system, the Romans used only 7 symbols only. They used only 7 symbols to write any big number. What are the 7 symbols they used in the Roman system? 1. V. X. L. C. D. M. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They use only 7 symbols or 7 digits to write the numbers. I for what? 1. I for V, that means 5. V represents 5. Next to X. X represents 10. And L represents 50. C represents 100. D represents 500. M represents 1000. So, this is here, Roman numerals. These are Indo-Arabic. So, here, 7 are there. There are 7 Roman numerals. In the Roman system, the Romans used only 7 symbols. Here, I have prepared a table here. In this table, the first one, the first row represents Romans, the second one, the corresponding Indo-Arabic numerals. Here, I for 1, V for 5, X for N, L for 50, C for 100, D for 500, M for 1000. Like this, we use the Roman numerals. And the numbers indicated by them in the Indo-Arabic system, that also we represented under the Roman numerals. Like this, we use Roman numerals and Indo-Arabic variants. Here symbols are given and Roman letters are given. Next one, see. For example, using these we can write some numbers. What are the numbers? Suppose here, any one number you take, suppose 2. How should we represent 2? I. Double. That means 1 plus 1 is equal to. This is the Roman symbolic form for the Indo-Arabic number. And by one more example, you see, suppose double X. I wrote double X. X represents what here? X represents 10. So a 20 is there. So how many times we write X? 2 times. That's why double X I wrote. That means here 10 plus 10. 20. One more example, you see. Okay. Any number you can take. Suppose here 5. 5. Here 5 is V for phi. And 4 you see, 4 like this way. 4 means IV. Here, V is the big one, I is the small one. Here, I wrote the smaller one to the left of bigger number. If we write a small number to the left of the bigger one, then subtraction. That means here, 5 minus 1 means 4. 5 is the 5, here V represents 5, I represents 1, and I wrote I to the left of the bigger number. If we write left side, then subtraction. If we write right side, what will happen is, suppose 6, V for what? 5. Now, addition, 5 plus 1. So, we write that smaller number 1 to the right side of V, like this. Here, V is the big one, I is the smaller. So, where we are writing the small to the big one? To this big one, we are writing to the right side of the big letter. That means, if we write right side, means then we add 5 plus 1. That is equal to 6. So, once you observe here, the smaller one is written to the left of the bigger one, then subtraction here. The smaller one, I, is written to the right side of the bigger number. That's why I added 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Like this, this is the combination. So, using these Roman numerals, we can write the Indo-Arabic numerals by following certain rules. So, in the rule 1, what is the rule 1? In the rule 1, we are. Rule 1 is mentioned in your book. What is the rule 1 mentioned? The 7 basic symbols can be used in different combinations involving addition or subtraction. That is the rule 1 to form the numbers. Now come to rule 2. What is the rule 2? Symbols IXCM can be repeated 3 times at any one given times. IXCM. IXCM. Suppose, in this rule 2, particularly these Roman numerals IXCM, we write 3 times, that's all. Maximum 3 times we write IXCM. Suppose, I write 3 times means, this is 3. X I wrote 2 times, that means 20. If I write x 3 times means 30, like c I wrote double time, that is 200. I write m 2 times, that means 2000. M 2 times I wrote m, then 1000 plus 1000, 2000. If I write 3 times means 1000 plus 1000, that is equal to 3000. Like this, in this rule 2, what is telling? Particularly the Roman numbers I, X, C, M. Repeatedly we can write. And there is a certain limit, in repeating this wrong. What is the maximum? 3 times. Maximum 3 times only we have to repeat this Roman numbers. That one only he mentioned in the
rule 2.
So rule 2, how he mentioned, you see one time in your book. Symbols I, X, C, M can be repeated 3 times. Can be repeated 3 times, particularly I, X, C, M. At any one given time, symbols, next one, see, the symbols V and D can be used only once at any one instance. V, L, D, symbols, V, L, D, only one time only. V, L, D can be used only once at any one instance. Only once at any one instance. But these are all numerals, I, X, C, M, repeated 3 times, I, X, C, M repeated 3 times at any one given time, like this. See, I wrote, suppose here, C, 3 times I wrote. Then what you say? It is a 300 plus 100 plus 100, that is equal to 300. Like this, we write the Roman letters by following this rule, that is rule 2 completed. Now we are going to rule 3. What is that rule 3? When the smaller number, when the smaller symbol is placed on the right of the bigger symbol, then we add the symbols. That is rule number 3. In the rule number 3, what is telling? If we write the smaller number symbol to the right side of the bigger number symbol, then we add, right side adding, left side subtraction. So in this rule, we write the smaller number symbol to the right side of the bigger symbol. For example, you see children. So this is rule number, what I wrote? 3. Rule 3. L. L means what? L represents 50. Now, take one smaller number. L is 50. Take one smaller number. X, can you take? X 10. X is smaller, L is 50, that is bigger. Now you write the smaller one to the right side. Right side. LX. This is a Roman number. LX represents a Roman number. What it represents in our Indo-Arabic system? What represents? That means here 50 plus 10. That is equal to 60. So LX represents 60. Why? Because X is smaller, that is written to the right side of the bigger. That's why here added. According to this rule, if any smaller number symbol is written to the right side of the bigger symbol, then we add 50 plus 10, 60. Like this, to each everyone you take. Like this, suppose we am taking D for what? 500. D for 500. Now take smaller one. C. C is the smaller one, D is the bigger. Now write C to the right side of D. Right. Then DC represents DC is the Roman numeral. Now we write it in the Indian Indo-Arabic system. That means 500. What we do here? Addition or subtraction? Addition. Why we are doing addition here? C for what? C for 100. 100 is added to 500. Why it was added means? Because the smaller number is placed to the right side of the bigger symbol. That's why add. 500 plus 100 is equal to 500 plus 100 is equal to 600. Now you see, suppose here M I wrote. And L, ML I wrote. What is this number? 1000, M for 1000. Here addition or subtraction? Addition. L for what?
50. L for 50.
Why added here? According to this rule, a smaller number is present to the right side of the bigger one. That's why 1000 plus 1050. Like this, by following this rule, we can write Indo-Arabic numerals. Rule 3 complete. Now we are going to the next rule. What is the next rule? Rule number 4. When the smaller symbol is placed on left of the bigger symbol, left of the bigger symbol, particularly keep mind this point. Left of the bigger symbol, then we subtract. This is the rule number 4. Once I can see. When the smaller number is placed to the left of the bigger symbol, then we subtract. That is rule number 5. For examples, now we are going to 4, 6, 9, 11. See? 4, 6, 9, 11. Here 4. 4 means here 5 minus 1, 4. 5 minus 1 means 4. What is the symbol of 5? V. Yeah, smaller number is 1. Where we write to left or right? Left way. Right. 5 minus 4. Now 6 you see. 6 means here. Yes. 5 plus 1 plus 1. 6. 5 plus 1 plus 1. 6. According to this rule, what we write here? Subtraction. Basing on subtraction now, we write. That means here 5, this is 6. Right side written add. If we write left side means addition. 5 plus 1 here 6. 9, 10, minus 1. 10 minus 1. 10 is the big one. 1 is the smaller. Where I wrote 1? Right side or left side? Left side. Left side means subtract. N minus 1, that is equal to 9. Okay. And one more example you see. Okay. 11. 10 plus 1. Right side. 10 plus 1. Before. Here I wrote before, that means the minus subtraction. Addition plus 10 plus 1. So here subtraction addition. In which case we write right side, and in which case we write left side, that we have to identify. Okay. So that is rule number. Okay. Rule number 5 is symbol I can be added to or subtracted from the next two symbols Vx only. Next one, see, symbol X can be added to or subtracted from the next two symbols. For example, here see combination. Let us take combination, addition and subtraction. Symbol X can be added to or subtracted from the next two symbols. LC. 40, 60, 90, 110. 40, 60, 90, 110. Let us study about the combinations. 40. 40 means here what? 50. Minus 10. 50 minus 10. Here 50, that means here 50 means here. Here subtraction. 50 minus 10. That means here we write that. XL. XL means what? 40. Here X is smaller, L is bigger. Smaller what is 10? To the left. Left side. That's why subtract. Now reverse it.
reverse, then what will happen? L, 6.
That means here,
50 plus 10,
60. Here, X, L is the big one, X is the smaller one. Smaller one is placed to the right side of the bigger one. That's why 50 plus 10, 60. Now 90 you take. 19 is what am I? 100 minus 10. 100 minus 10. 100 minus 10 is equal to 90. So here, C for 100. Now, where should we write X? X means 10. Where should we write right side or right side to the C or left side to the C? So here we write left side of C. Why? Because the smaller one, if we write smaller one to the left of the bigger one, then subtraction 100 minus 10. 100 minus 10 is equal to 90. Okay. Now 110 you see. Take combination. C for 100. 100 plus 10 or 110. CX. 100 plus 10 or 100. X to C. Reverse. Take reverse. That means if we take reverse, means 90. X to C. This is CX. X to C. CX. Here. Add. Here. Subtract. Subtracted, minus, added here, plus. In the addition, smaller symbol came to the right side. In the subtraction, smaller one came to the, in the subtraction. Okay, left side. X is written to the left. Symbol C can be added or subtracted from the next two symbols. DM, this is the last one. DM. Suppose, 400, 600, 900. These rules, taking some examples, by using some examples, we are implementing the rules and the regulations in writing the wrong numbers. So here, 400, 600, 900, and one big number also we can take, that is here 11. So 400, how should we write? 500 minus 100. What is the Roman numeral of 500? D. Here subtraction. Subtraction means here where we write left or right side, that means left side. That means CD we write. CD. That means this is 400. 500 minus 400. 600 you see, 500 plus 100. So D for 500, here plus is there, addition is there. So in the combination of addition we write C to the right side of D. D is the bigger one, to this bigger symbol we write C to the right side. Then 500 plus 100 is equal to 600. Now 900. 900 is very near to 1000. 900 is very near to 1000. Just how much less it is? Just only 100 less. Only 100 less than 1000. That's why 1000 minus 100. 1000 minus 100. So here M for 1000 minus subtraction. That's why C we write to the left of M. Last one. Here 1100. This is how much more than 1000? Just 100 more than 1000. That's why here 1000 plus 100. M for 1000. Now here addition is there now. That's what I said. 1000 plus 100. 1000 M for 1000 plus C 100. 1000 plus 100 is 1000. 100. Like this, using the rules, we write numbers. Okay, children, I think you are all followed about these rules and regulations. How to write the numbers? Roman to Indo-Arabic and Indo-Arabic to Roman.